Hey everybody, Invisible Katana here, playing Skullgirls Second Encore. The reason I'm starting off on the actual loading up music and everything is because I just love the style of the music, and I kind of want to go through this whole thing just because it looks cool and I like the music that plays, and it's stylistically very well done, of course. And oddly enough, and like I was going through this because I'm once again doing like my cheap audio move where I'm recording audio on OBS as well. To try to make it easier for like the next couple of times I have a set audio. Like it always takes a lot of time when I first do it because I have to go through and make sure my audio is like perfect for when I record. And then that way when I do it from now on, every episode it'll be way easier for me to record just so I can do them faster, obviously. But I wanted to go through this because I love the design for this. I love getting to see all the characters. Of course, I bought this on Steam, and it being the second Encore, and everything being on sale, I bought all the DLC, so Squiggly is one of the DLC characters, Big Ban, so I have all the DLC characters, both free and paid. I have all of the, costume DLC, which is why the name of this episode is Panty and Stocking, because I'm gonna be playing with Philia right there, and one of her costumes is actually, Scanny and Knee Socks, and if you never saw that anime, then that won't really make any difference to you. But it's basically her with red skin. Was it red skin? Yeah, red skin and like really bright green hair. Here we go. Story mode. Philia! You know what? Oh, crap. I did not know you only got to play as one person. Alright, so what I'm gonna do is skip this first, and then I'm gonna go back. Yeah, because that's not the costume I wanted at all. So,
gentlemen and ladies, it's showtime! Just a moment. Cool. You can't quit now!
I think I know that voice. Also, that was something else I found out. I had no idea that, just go to training, it'll probably be easier. I had no idea that you could, every button is a costume, so it's like I have to go through all of these things. And you can hear that a million times. Even, oh my goodness, they have press two buttons, you get a new costume. Oh, actually, is that supposed to be Kill la Kill? Because that's what that looks like to me. Jeez, on the Christ. Sorry that this is already going crazy, but I gotta find that costume, because otherwise what's the point in titling it? There it is! Holy crap. X and B, I gotta remember that. That is Scanny and Stocking, or Scanny and Knee Socks from Panty and Stocking. They're basically the evil counterparts to the heroes of Panty and Stocking with Garterbelt. If you're into anime and you've never seen Panty and Stocking with Garterbelt, by the way, hilarious. And I'm gonna be super pissed if I did all that just now and when I get to her thing it's still her regular costume. That would suck. But these are really cool. I like this. Oh well, well, what have we here? What's that? Buy you a real drink, sister. Oh, it's grabbing the booty. That's like, we've already got a drink, thanks. And that would be her hair talking, that's who Samson is. that's quite the deep voice you got there, little lady, but it's cool. That's it, you had a chance to walk away. A parasite. I love, like, the music on this is just, like, the calm style of music, and it's just like, you could just nod your head to it, and then it's just like living hair just beat up a guy who's just like squeezing on her butt. Samson, you've got to stop doing that. You're drawing too much attention to us. There's also a full-on clear panty shot in that last scene. I'm sure you guys noticed that, because their skirt isn't exactly long. The creep was asking for it. No one lays a hand on my host. No one. I know you mean well, but I can take care of myself. Anyway, where to next? It's funny seeing her with the hat on, because I don't think I ever really noticed that in her opening. We need leads on the skull heart. Gotta wish my memories back. Oh, amnesia. Definitely a new meridian. I can feel it. Which it kind of showed in the poster that she had amnesia and stuff. It was super quick, but it kind of gave info on their on the characters. With all these Skullgirl rumors floating around, I bet we can find a lead just by looking for trouble. Fine, we'll do it your way. Like, the music is so, yeah, see, it's so fast with the hat on.
Gentlemen, it's ladies, super quick. It's showtime!
Okay, like I was, yeah, and it's a regular costume, so that's like, so I have to change the title to something else. But it'll have Panty Stocking in there, because we're gonna have her. I always wanted that girl to be a person, and that's also Ryu in the background, I just realized. With the... I never noticed him in the background ever in the demo. And I just realized that like his his little punching bag even has a face on it. Totally possible, lady. KO. Okay, I wish I could have used her other costume.
You're about to have a bad hair day.
Roll camera and fight!
Garterbelt is the other character that I know how to play with a little bit. It's been a long time since I played the demo, but honestly, I played the crap out of the demo. Like, you wouldn't believe. And Sarabella and Philia, I always hated that special because it takes so much health. But Sarabella and Philia were always the two characters that I used, because those were the two in the demo. Unfortunately, after a while, the demo swapped out, and so it became like Peacock, and I believe Parasol, man. I couldn't mention it because I totally screwed up laughing at the Ryu and his little punching bag there. But the girl that was in the background that had like the gold gauntlets, I always thought like it would be cool. I love that pose too. Always thought it'd be really cool if she had oh, that's so gross. Philia. Get ready, Philia. I don't think we can get away from that thing. Ooh, connections. I was hoping it would be like that, because I was like, oh, you just go through fighting everyone.
Try to keep it cute, huh? Let's rock!
Yeah, but the character in gold, I always wanted to, always thought could have been a cool character. Because I believe Big Man, who is one of the DLC characters, the first, no DLC character. Dang, I totally forgot what I was about to say. Oh, thought that character should have been DLC all the time. Let's get in here before that thing wakes up. Let's see, who was I? What does this poor girl know me? Don't know. She's clearly insane. Oh, Painwell actually has a name. Even Samson opened his mouth on that one. Oh, they're sisters? They must be sisters. Interesting. See, I never knew the story to the game. I knew it was like, get the skull heart. I never knew that it did all this different stuff.
Gentlemen and ladies, it's showtime!
Something else that I found out just today is that you can actually change. Oh, man. The other thing I found out today was the changing the announcer voices. Oh, jeez. Destroy me with those. Okay. So, changing the announcer to female I thought was pretty cool because I was so used to the guy voice. And I didn't know that there was a difference. Hit her head. I guess it doesn't do that much. Good enough.
Don't like them.
And it'd be interesting if you could fight like that the whole time. Another failed experiment. Oh, Valentine. The sexy one. Clearly. Sorry I just stopped reading, but my very pan reading isn't worth doing, so I'm just reading in my head for you guys. Those are pretty heads. I didn't know Valentine was a villain. That kind of sucks. I guess someone had to be the villain, no? So she even has a statue of herself in creepy form in the background. Oh, that is disgusting. I've never noticed that before, but that just looks super gross in still version. Like the teeth, the side teeth. Something about that has always affected me. Almost like Attack on Titan, how they have that where you can like see the jaw and stuff like that. Oh, both of them. Like that doesn't look as gross. I know that voice. And I'm pretty sure it's someone who's done voices for anime before. Which wouldn't surprise me that they got someone from an anime because they have a ton of anime references. Like one of Sarabella's moves is a move that's really popular in the Naruto anime. It's what Kakashi does. I forgot the real name of it. It's an actual thing that's done in Japan. Like when people put their fingers together and stick in the butt. That's a thing. And Kakashi does that a lot in Naruto. It calls it the Thousand Years of Death. And Sarabella has that as a Sarabella has that as a technique. So funny to me. Maybe I should have put it on hard difficulty, but maybe it's because it's Sarabella. I sort of know how to use her. Very nice. Right after I'm like, I should have put it on hard. Hits me with an epic 12-hit combo. I've never seen that special before either. Yeah, obviously I don't really know the moves too well. I forgot all the moves, really. And I never really knew the specials. I was kind of always button mashing to do specials, except for, oddly enough, the one where she's like, Banshee, that one I remembered, and now I can't do it. And I say Banshee all the time because of this game, too. Love the music for this one, too. It's nice, threatening. That looks so cool. That's definitely, you know, anime-esque. It's really awesome. Marie, like the little girl, of course. Meet again, but why? system. Alright, let's take down the Skullgirl. I do really love the art for this game. Holy crap.
Everyone good to go?
I'm screwed. It's just like... What's happening? What's that?
Take it,
yeah. It's like, I don't know where the attacks are gonna come from. She's like taking... What? What? She's taking like no damage, basically. Whoa. Oh, come on. Oh, my goodness. Like, she just suddenly goes, like, hardcore on me. It's like, I'm scared to even... Yeah. It's like, I'm scared to move now, because she's suddenly just going, like, Shadows! Crazy villain. I love the design though. She also has the little evil worm. Just funny and cute. Jeez. I'm trying to kind of test her moves. Oh, I didn't do that.
Oh. Know your place. You dare challenge me? See how weak you are.
See, that's the one that's real difficult to...
Know your place. You dare challenge me?
What? Jeez. This is not the type of fight you want to have. Where you... Jeez. Oh, come on. I don't think I'm gonna make it. And you can still do that, huh? Isn't that always the most insulting thing ever? It's like, and you die. It was like the simplest move that they have, and it just takes you down. And it's like, it makes you feel worse than anything.
Try to keep it cute, huh? Let's rock.
That's right. Alright, so that I do believe is a reference to Devil May Cry 3, the opening. That is like that's right. And it pushes the I'm gonna have to go to the menu so I can get the, I need my, the banshee attack, the butterfly move, so I can do a forward dash, because that's the one that I really need to, Yeah, see, I keep doing that move by accident. I should also block more. I'm horrible at blocking. I don't know. I haven't done a lot of fighting games on the channel yet. But I am probably one of the worst blocking people you will ever see. Like, I do it so rarely. Like, that's how I lose a lot, because I don't block enough. Man, if that didn't knock me back every time, it wouldn't be such a... Try to do this real quick. Born with it, Fenrir Drive. That might be the one. Yeah. Okay. Alright, let's see how that plays out. Ooh, what? Yeah, I know.
You can't quit now!
Always like this in fighting games for me. I'm basically gonna end the episode, hopefully, by defeating.
Let's do this in one take.
Yeah. And once you get caught in that, you cannot.
You've got a lot to learn.
Man. After a while, you just get like so frustrated. Like, it. Oh man, it's like this in so many fighting games, though. Honestly, I mean, it's nothing new. Where it's like, oh man, I'm like wailing through everybody, go through enemies and jump. I wish she still did the other half of that move, even. Yeah, like if she went up and still came down. This might be the one. Ah. Should have gone for on that one. Oh my goodness. It drives me insane, but got it. Alright. Woo! Way too close. Heart was racing. She looks totally different from that angle. She's probably gonna wish for her sister, if that is her sister, back to normal. Your wish has been granted. Almost. What does that mean? Does that mean she's gonna become full hair or something? Makes me think of Super Mario World. Pain wheel. Must be foreign. Oh, you can see her veins. And her face. That was mean. But dang, when you look like that, it's hard not to notice. You look like Frankenstein's monster. The lamps, and I like sewing and puppies and walks on the beach. It's like some Scott Pilgrim stuff. See, what does that mean? I guess if you win the Skull Heart, you transform into the next Skull Girl. I definitely thought there was going to be dialogue right there, but oh well. Just in time. That's a good amount of time. Thanks for joining me for this episode. I was not... That was just a crazy ending fight there. It was pretty intense. But definitely love this first go-through. I'm probably going to do, I think I'll go through and do some stuff in the next episode with the three characters at one time, to actually have the Scanny and Esox thing, because I had no idea that you had to have, all the characters' regular costumes, so that does kind of suck to have to do that in the story mode, and it, obviously it's not that big of a deal, it doesn't matter that much. Because I like pretty much all their regular costumes. Obviously, I just wanted to do, specific costume so I could do the panty and stocking thing. So I'll probably do it in the next episode. But thanks for joining me, guys. If you have any comments, of course, put them down in the comment section below. I don't know when I'll upload this. I might try to upload it today, but definitely let me know what story I should play next. I'm probably gonna end up doing that in the next episode. After I play a couple matches with three characters, or I'll probably just go straight into another story mode because I kind of want to, just to see it, because I've done the fighting but haven't experienced any of the real stories yet. So I'll probably do that with Sarah Bella next, because that's the other character I know a lot because of the demo. So thanks for joining me for this one. Like I said, if you guys have any comments, please put them down in the comment section below, and please join me in the next part.